بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أما بعد. It's important for us to know who Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah is. What does it mean, Ahl Sunnah? Ahl Sunnah, that refers to those people who try to follow the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam with the understanding of the Sahaba radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. So that is the methodology, the madhab, and the minhaj of the Salaf of this Ummah. And when we refer to the Salaf of this Ummah, we're referring to the Sahaba radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in, the Tabi'een, their students, may Allah have mercy upon them, and the next generation, the students of the Tabi'een. That's when we refer to the Salaf, we're talking about the first three generations of Islam. How many generations of Islam are we referring to? The first three. Now, and the first generation is who? Is during the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is the Sahaba radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. Then the Tabi'een, those people who followed them, who were their students, that were on righteousness, that met Sahaba as Muslims and died as Muslims. And then the Itba' Tabi'een, those people who came after them. And Ibn al-Qayyim, rahimahullah ta'ala, he's a great imam, Shaykh al-Islam. He was a student of a great scholar named Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah. He has a beautiful statement about the Sahaba and following the minhaj of Ahl Sunnah, to following the way of Ahl Sunnah. Because that's who we are. We're Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. We follow the Quran. We try to understand the Quran as the Sahaba understood the Quran. We follow their minhaj and their fiqh and how they understood and their aqidah and their way of da'wah and the way and the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's what we try to follow. And the way and understanding of the Salaf. Those people, those first three generations. That's how we try to follow that path. So that's what makes a person Ahl Sunnah. If they're trying to follow that path, they're not just using it as a name, but rather they are practicing it and trying to achieve it and attain it, even with shortcomings, that they are from Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Shaykh al-Islam Ibn al-Qayyim, rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, وَكُلُّ مِنَ الصَّحَابَةِ مُنِيبٌ إِلَى اللَّهِ فَيَجِبُ اتْبَعَ سَبِيلِهِ وأقواله واعتقاداته من أكبر سبيله ودليل على أنهم منيبون إلى الله تعالى أن الله قد هداهم وقد قال ويهدي إليه من ينيب. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, and every one of the Sahaba, all the Sahaba, they were making tawbah to Allah. They were all trying to come closer to Allah. They were all making tawbah. That's why they were all righteous. All the Sahaba were righteous. Even if they made a mistake or something, they were still the righteous. They're the best of this ummah. And their mistakes, bi-idhnillah, are forgiven. The Sahaba, radiyallahu ta'ala anhum, they're the best of this nation. And that's why we try to follow their sunnah as well as the sunnah, first and foremost, of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We follow the way of the Sahaba because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Alaykum bi sunnati wa sunnat al-khulafa rashidin al-mahdin." He said, it's upon you my sunnah and the rightly guided khalifah, meaning that you have to follow Abu Bakr, and you have to follow Umar, and you have to follow Uthman, and you have to follow Ali. Radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. That their sunnah is also very important. But their sunnah, of course, if they did something out of ijtihad that seemed to go against the what we know of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his sunnah, then of course we don't follow that. We follow the sunnah, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, is the asl. And their understanding, radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. So Ibn al-Qayyim said, all the Sahaba were making tawbah to Allah. And it is an obligation to follow them. You have to follow the Sahaba in their statements and what they said, those narrations about the Sahaba, and their ittiqad, their belief, what they believe, because they have the belief of Ahl Sunnah. That's how we know the Sunnah, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's how it was transmitted through the Sahaba radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. And that's how the Quran is with us, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala preserved it through the Sahaba radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. So we have to follow their aqidah, not the aqidah of the Ash'aris or the aqidah of the Naqshbandis, or the Aqidah of the Brailouis, or the Aqidah of the various Sufi groups, but instead we follow the Sunnah of Ahl Sunnati wal Jama'ah, the Sunnah and the Aqidah of the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhu ajma'in. So Ibn al-Qayyim said, and he said the evidence for this, that we have to follow their way, is that, and that they are, the evidence that they are, that they were seeking to come close to Allah, they were making tawbah, is that Allah gave them guidance. And Allah said in the Quran that He guides to it, meaning the sabil, the sirat al-mustaqim, the righteous path, the straight path, those people who make repentance, you need. And so that shows, because the Sahaba were guided to Islam, that shows that they were rightly guided, and that they were those people who munib, those people who make tawbah to Allah, and sought Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's forgiveness and guidance. Radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. That's why we follow the Sahaba to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because that's what Ahl Sunnah does. Ahl Sunnah loves Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and loves the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his way, and loves the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in, all of the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in, and follows their way. And Allah was pleased with the Sahaba. That's why Allah said in the Quran, وَقَدْ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْ السَّحَابَ وَعَمَّا تَبَعَهُمْ بِإِحْسَانٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with the Sahaba and those who followed them in righteousness. قَالَ تَعَالَى وَالصَّابِقُونَ الْأَوَّلُونَ مِنَ الْمُهَاجِرِينَ وَالْأَنصَارِ وَالَّذِينَ تَبَعُهُمْ بِإِحْسَانٍ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ وَرَضُوا عَنْهُ وَعَدَّ لَهُمْ جنات تجري من تحت الانهار خالدين فيها أبدا ذلك الفوز العظيم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah At-Tawbah about the Sahaba, this is about the Sahaba, so don't believe those people, those Rafi, the Shia, those people who curse the Sahaba. They make takfir of the Sahaba. They call the Sahaba kuffar, and they call the Sahaba wicked sinners, and they say Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha was a zani, was an adulteress. A'udhu billah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala break their backs, their evil backs. Wa'iyadhu billah min thalika. Those people who curse and make takfir of the Sahaba, they're not from Ahl Sunnah. And between us and them is like the East and the West. And between us and them, there's enmity and there's dislike and hatred. Why? Because they hate the Sahaba to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And in fact, they hate the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because if you hate the Sahaba, you hate Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because he's the one, salawatu rabbi wa salamu alayhi, who said that you need to love the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in, and follow their sunnah. So if you don't like their sunnah and you don't want to follow their sunnah, it's as if you're saying you don't want to follow the sunnah and the message of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in that ayat, then those who proceeded from the first, from the muhajireen and the ansar. Do you know who the muhajireen were? The muhajireen were those people who left Mecca. They made the hijrah to Medina. They immigrated from Mecca to Medina. Those were sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. For min al muhajireen wal ansar. Well, the ansar were the people of Medina. They're called the ansar, and they helped the people of Mecca who made hijrah radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. وَالَّذِينَ اتَّبَعُهُمْ وَالَّذِينَ اتَّبَعُهُمْ بِإِحْسَانٍ. And those people who follow them in righteousness. So if you follow the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum in righteousness and good deeds, and following their aqidah, what they believe in, their minhaj, their methodology of doing dawah, and their methodology of Islam, then you will be under that ayat. Those people who follow them in righteousness, Allah is pleased with them, and they are pleased with Allah. And Allah has promised them paradise under which rivers flow forever. They will abide in it forever. And that is the greatest success. If you want the greatest success, it's not playing for the NBA. The greatest success is not being a lawyer or a doctor. The greatest success is if you live and die as a Muslim. وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. Don't die except as a Muslim. And you die as a Muslim, and you go to Jannah to Firdaus because you follow the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and you follow the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. That's the fawzul azim, ya bunayya. If you want to be successful in this life as well as the hereafter, be from Ahl Sunnah. Be from the Salafiyun. Don't be Salafi. And follow Kitabillah wa Sunnah to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the way of the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in, and do righteous deeds and try to get to Jannah. And if Allah blesses you with Jannah to Firdaus, then you have gotten the Fawzul Azeem. And we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all with Jannah to Firdaus, and bless us to be from Ahl al-Sunnati wal Jama'ah, and bless us to worship Him in a manner that pleases Him. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.